Welcome. You know, when a magician says, pick a card, they usually go like this, face down, and you don't really know what card it is. I mean, they might force you to take one that, I don't know, you don't want. Or what if the magician sneaks a look at it when you're not paying attention? Not me. Not tonight. Your name is?
Alexandria.
Alexandria.
Because Alex is basic in the demo.
Alexandria, I'm going to let you look at the cards, and you can choose anyone you want.
Okay.
Just tell me when to stop at any time.
Stop.
Do you see one you want?
Yes.
If you don't, I'll keep going.
No, no, no. I see
take
one.
Your card.
Okay.
Let me go. Got
Am
it?
I supposed
is that
to
it?
Show you?
No, take
just
it. Hold on to
okay.
it.
Okay.
Alexandria.
Yes.
This is the ultimate in mind reading. But Alexandria, I'm not going to read your mind. Hey Siri, call the wizard.
Calling the wizard mobile.
The wizard's got a mobile.
Okay. Should I pick up?
Hello?
Is this the wizard?
This could be the wizard.
Wizard, it's Magic Randy. I'm in Las Vegas with about 35 of my closest friends. Alexandria is holding a card. Hold it gently, don't tear it, just
okay.
Gently. Wizard, what card did she choose?
Okay, Alexandria. There may be a little bit of, let's see here, I'm over in Florida, but you guys are in Las Vegas?
Yes.
Okay. The card's slowly coming over. First thing that's coming over is the color of the card. It's coming over, I think it's a red card. Alexandra, is it a red card?
She's smiling, so
it
I think so far
card.
So good.
Keep going, okay. Keep going.
Okay, all right, 50-50. Okay, two red cards. I like to joke, because I go, women usually choose the red cards. I joke that they go for love or money. I'm thinking there's some fortune in Alexandria's
I love this
future. I'm gonna go with the diamond.
Gosh, no way. Keep
so
going.
So far,
wizard.
So good.
Okay. Now the difficult part. Let's see here. Now the number of the card. I say number because I don't think she chose a court card, the Jack, Queen, or King. But I think she chose the best diamond in the deck. I'm gonna go with the Ace of Diamonds.
Show us, Alexandria. Wizard, you got it! Thank you, Wizard, and thank you, Alexandria. Next up, and you'll notice that every single magic routine that I do, you have a choice of any card in the deck. I'll never force you to take one, and you'll have the opportunity to choose any card. So, right here in front of me, I need to know who at this table is a skeptic. Who says there's no way the magician's gonna fool me tonight? One of you, I'm sure.
Not a chance.
Your name?
Justin.
Justin, I'm Randy. It's nice to meet you. You know how this works, Justin. You can just tell me when to stop at any time and take any card you wish.
Stop.
Please, take your card. Is that it?
Well, the becomes a wonderland. It's magic. Well, how else can I explain those rainbows when there is no rain? It's magic.
Justin, it's time. Performance, right? Next up is a routine which is very near and dear to my heart. It is the world famous Magic Randy, that's me, quarter through the table magic trick. Got a quarter, got a table, it's gonna go right through. Now, what kind of trick would it be if we didn't have someone to mix up the cards? Your name, please?
Suzanne.
Suzanne, you get to mix and shuffle the cards a little bit. Oh, and your name?
Talon,
you get to sign the quarter. No one's ever signed a quarter before, Talon. You can just put a T on there if you wish. Oh, on the other side, Talon, I'd like you to put any symbol or emoji that you'd like on the back of the quarter, something you'll recognize no matter what. Did you do it?
Yes.
Oh, and
Cindy.
Suzanne. You get to cut the deck. Now, this is your only opportunity, Suzanne, to make a change. Do you want to go any more or any less?
No, I think we're good here.
We're going to come back to this at the very end. And now, a prediction based on Suzanne's shuffling of the deck. This prediction is made. And I'm going to place the deck on top of the prediction for this, the world famous Magic Randy quarter through the table magic trick. The quarter doesn't just fall right through, Talon, you know. The first thing we need is to give it some weight. That's why I brought this salt shaker. And that should be just enough weight for this, the moderately famous Magic Randy quarter through the table magic trick. Next thing we need is darkness, right? All magicians need darkness. So I brought my darkness paper, and that'll be perfect as I wrap it around my weight salt shaker for this, the world famous Magic Randy quarter through the table magic trick. Not yet. Last thing we need, promise, last thing we need, and that is to find the magic soft spot on the table. I'm sure you all know what that is, don't you? Of course you do! It's a place on the table where objects, like little quarters, will fall right through. What if I said the soft spot was right there? Would you believe it?
No,
it's not. What if I said the soft spot was just about there? What do you think? I think we found it.
Oh.
But everyone says, Randy, the quarter hasn't gone through the table. They're right. I'm going to take next my darkness paper and give it the push through the same spot on this table. And it also goes right through. But this is, as I said, the famous quarter through the table trick. You might even hear it go through. And that's the world famous Magic Randy quarter through the, wait! There was a little bit more to the trick. Suzanne, you, if you recall, cut the deck.
Yes.
And today, you cut to the nine of hearts. The prediction is still underneath. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and show everyone exactly what the prediction says. It says you're going to cut to the nine of hearts. But wait, there's even more to the prediction. Do you know what that is, Suzanne? Tell me what that is. That's the T quarter before and after I folded it in half when you weren't looking. Talon, is that the quarter you signed? Because that's the world famous Magic Randy folded quarter through the table magic trick. Talon, I want you to keep that. That's for you, keep. To remember our time together. That's the quarter through the table magic trick. Next up, guys, would it be okay if I took a quick break from magic to play a game?
Sure. Yeah.
A little game? It's a little game of skill and intrigue known the world over as Noughts and Crosses, or as we call it in the US, tic-tac-toe. What's your name?
Ivan.
Ivan, I'm Randy. Ivan, will you play?
Yeah, of course.
Let me move these drinks out of the way. Ivan, I challenge you. I'm gonna go first. I'm gonna be X's, and Ivan, I'm going right in the middle. You're the circles, please, go anywhere you want. Yep. Ivan, I'm gonna go right there. It's gonna be a very short game, Ivan, if you have never played tic-tac-toe. All right, you got it, you got it. Let's see, I'm gonna go right here. Ivan, it's wide open, you can go anywhere you want. I like it, going for the win. I got to block you by going here, but this is my last chance to win. This is it. All right, nobody won, nobody lost. That was fun, I had a good time. Did you enjoy that?
It was good.
Yeah. But if you'll notice, the box
prediction
has a prediction of the outcome, and it says that Ivan and I will play to a draw. You're not impressed. I think you will be. Because when I say the box has a prediction of the outcome, what I mean is the box has a prediction of the outcome. And Ivan, it's perfect.
It's a match for match.
O-X-O-X-O-X-O-X. That's how magicians tic-tac-toe. Well, I'm looking at the clock, and I think I'm going to try my semi-grand finale. We'll give this a quick try. Suzanne,
yes.
I hope you'll help out one more time.
Sure.
If you could please give the deck of cards what's called a triple cut, right on the table. Cut twice. And then you'll complete the cuts from left to right. Next, Suzanne, if you'll please give the cards a single riffle shuffle. That's where you shuffle half the deck into the other half. This randomizes their order. And finally, Suzanne, give the cards a straight cut. That's where you cut and complete. Now, this gives them a new starting point. By Las Vegas standards, these cards are thoroughly shuffled. Hold them face down in your hand, and you're going to deal out five cards face down. And on top of each one, another card face down. And you're going to keep doing that till you have five piles of five cards each. I often call this liar's poker because you all have an opportunity to try to, well, see how good of a liar you are. Thank you, Suzanne. Suzanne, one of the piles will go to someone at the table. Please choose anyone you want and hand them a pile. And your name?
Thank you, Tom.
Tom gets a pile. Next, someone else, please. Your name?
Talon.
Talon, of course. You are?
DeAndre.
DeAndre, please hold on to those. I'll get one, and you'll get one. Okay. I want you to all have a look at this little pile of cards you have. This is not a poker hand, but instead I want you to memorize one card. Choose any card you wish, and burn it into your memory. Suzanne, you have one memorized?
Yes.
DeAndre?
Yes.
Dan?
Tom?
And Talon. I've got the T's confused. Suzanne?
Yes.
Cards come back. DeAndre? Are they all mixed up? Cards come back. Dan cards come back and Talon cards come back. When we began, I asked you to do something called a triple cut. Do you remember?
Yes.
Then I said you're gonna do something called a riffle shuffle. That's where you shuffle half the deck into the other. And then finally I said you're gonna do something called a straight cut. Then I had you deal out five piles of five cards each. And you all memorized a single card. I'm gonna pick them up one at a time and I'll ask, somewhere, do you see your card in this little pile, Suzanne? The card you memorized, the card you memorized is here. Yes. DeAndre, how about you, your card, is it somewhere in this pile?
Yes.
It both
no
of you.
Way.
Of course. No.
Dan, no, and Talon?
No.
No. We'll start with Suzanne. I want you to take this very seriously, Suzanne. Look at the cards, and I'm just gonna go like this and watch your eyes. Oh, they went right to these. Suzanne, I'm gonna try this again. I think you're trying to look at this one, which tells me the four of clubs has to be your card.
Yes.
We're one for one. DeAndre, you're next. For you, DeAndre, we're gonna go from eyes to lies. I'm gonna ask you about each of these one at a time, and I want you to lie as much as you want. You can say yes to all of them, no to all of them, throw us off. You see, we're watching your visual cues. We're listening to your vocal inflection, trying to determine when you're lying and telling the truth. DeAndre, was this your card?
No.
They usually start with a lie, just so you know. Was this your card?
No.
Was this your card?
No.
Was this your card?
No.
He said no to all of them. He had to be lying one time. When did you hear it? Anyone?
First one at first?
I'm gonna say it was the second card, the four of hearts, that's my guess. We're two for two! Dan, is your card somewhere here?
Yes.
It is! And Talon?
No.
No, it's not. For you, a personality test. Oh. Dan, in the time we've gotten to know each other, I'm gonna determine which card you would have chosen based on the suits of the cards. You know, there are four suits and they have different meanings. The first one is the diamonds, represents wealth and like showing off a lot of bling. I don't think so. The other red suit, the heart. Maybe lust is your sin, or you're a person of deep love or friendship. The black suits, the club, the clover. Maybe you rely on luck to make your fortune. Or the spade, the knife. Maybe you stab your friends in the back. Well, in the time we've gotten to know each other, I can't believe it. You think of yourself very fondly. I think you rely on luck, and I think you're a perfect 10.
That's my card.
Is your card here?
Yes.
It is! So it's none of these and none of these. For you, the question mark. This box has been in front of you the whole time. And inside is not a deck of cards. In fact, they're all completely blank, except for a prediction I made earlier. Two cards I have, one of which represents the number or value of your card, and the other one represents the suit. All the rest are completely blank. Now, I'm committed. I cannot change my mind. Can you look through those cards and tell us which card you selected tonight? Please have a look at the pile of cards and tell us which one you chose. The King of Diamonds. I'm sorry. I told you one of these cards represents the value or number, and it is the King. The other one is the suit. It's the diamonds.
Oh my God.
King of Diamonds, and that's Randy's Liar's Poker.